Hello, friends, and welcome to Coffee and Conversation. Encouragement for today. A ray of hope coming from the Gordon Avenue Baptist Church in Adel, Georgia. And friend, there's just not a better place to find a ray of hope than in the light of God's holy and precious word. Let me invite you today to pick up your Bible, turn with me, if you will, to Philippians chapter 4, and let's look at verse 11 as a text verse of Scripture. Notice what the Bible says here. Not that I speak in respect of want, for I have learned in whatever state I am therewith to be content. And friends, I pray that God would add his wonderful blessings to the reading of his holy and precious word. Get that good fresh cup of hot coffee. Let's sit together, have an encounter with God and his precious word on this beautiful day. My goodness. Friend, there's just not a better way to start a brand new day than a good fresh cup of hot coffee and a fresh word from God. Well, today I want to bring to you a devotional thought that is titled Defined by Contentment. My friend, the story is told of two teardrops that were floating down the river of life. One of the teardrops asked the other, "Who are you?" The second teardrop replied, "I am the teardrop from a girl who loved a man and lost him." "But who are you?" The first teardrop replied, "I am a teardrop from the girl who got him." That's the way life goes, my friend, isn't it? We cry over what we don't have, not realizing we might have cried twice as hard had we gotten it. One of the reasons the Apostle Paul lived a life characterized by such joy and gratitude was because he had learned the secret of being content. He was thankful for what he had and not sorry about what he didn't have. Paul passed on that secret to his new converts while living in the end of his age. He told the Corinthians to be content where they were. My friend, he urged them not to be envious and try to gain what they didn't have, because the time is short. We live some 2,000 years later, so friend, the time is even shorter. My friend, learn to be content where you are, with what and who you are, and what you have. People who are content live with a flexible cup. That cup expands or contracts to fit what God has supplied. Think about that, my friend. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this powerful, powerful devotion. And we pray that you'll use it in the lives of your people to find contentment and happiness and joy that is our strength in the Lord. For I make my prayer in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Well, friends, I pray the devotion has been a blessing to you today. And if it has, you be a blessing to someone else by sharing it with them. And remember, your life is the Bible some may read every day. Let others see and hear Jesus in what you say and in what you do. Again, God bless you. Have a wonderful day.